Troubleshooting, oil analysis, contamination and resulting problems. We need one or more perfectly clean graduated jugs, special test for the verification of the type of oil, special test for the verification of the oil acidity, screwdriver or ratchet, socket wrench sized according to the type of the compressor. We also need safety helmet, safety goggles, safety gloves, safety shoes. Attention! Keep and read the instruction manual carefully and always respect the safety warnings contained in it. How to verify if the oil contained in the compressor is appropriate. First of all, make sure the compressor is placed on a flat surface to proceed with the oil level check. In this case, we can observe that the oil level is slightly low. Identify the position of the oil drain screw on the compressor. The oil drain screw is usually located at the lowest point of the flange on the cylinder side. For further details, refer to the Frascold selection software FSS3. Tilt the compressor towards the oil drain screw to facilitate the drainage procedure. Check for the presence of pressure inside the compressor by opening the taps or by removing the pressure plugs on the taps. In this case, the compressor has no taps, but it has closing flanges, which need to be removed slowly and carefully. Wait until the compressor is completely depressurized. Remove the oil drain screw with a screwdriver or ratchet and drain the oil into one or more clean jugs. Attention! If, while the oil is being drained, the typical white foam forms on the surface of the oil, which is a symptom of the presence of refrigerant, wait for it to disappear completely. In this way, the exact oil level will be checked and the test will not be altered due to the possible presence of gas. Make sure that the amount of oil in the compressor is suitable. The required quantity can be checked by consulting Frascold selection software FSS3. In this case, we can observe that the oil level is slightly low. Proceed to the oil test. We will use an oil test with reagents. To proceed with the test, take the amount of oil indicated on the technical datasheet of the test being used. Take the special test bottle. Pour in the amount of oil taken, close and shake the bottle. Compare the visual result of the test with the instruction manual supplied with the kit. In this case, we are in the presence of a polyester oil. Make sure that the type of oil contained in the compressor is suitable for it by referring to the compressor plate. In this case, we can observe that the oil type is correct. How to check the oil acidity? Through the use of an oil acidity test, take the amount of oil indicated on the technical data sheet of the kit being used, take the special test bottle and pour in the amount of oil taken. close and shake the bottle and check the color of the reagent. Compare it with the instruction manual supplied with the test to check the oil acidity. In this case, we can observe that the oil has a high level of acidity. Troubleshooting. The results of the two previous tests shows us that the oil level is slightly below the necessary threshold, but it is still sufficient. The oil type is correct for the compressor. The oil has a high level of acidity. This leads to the following problems. The high level of acidity alters the insulation of the stator, damaging it irreparably. We can also see how the strong acidity of the oil has compromised the insulation, causing the overheating of the stator and melting the bindings. The high level of acidity of the oil can also lead to poor lubrication of the compressor crank mechanism, which may result in seizure in worst cases. As we have seen in this case, the lines on the crankshaft are a sign of seizure caused by poor lubrication due to overly acidic oil. The same has happened on the connecting rods, which feature the same type of marks and therefore signs of seizure. How to avoid these problems? To avoid the acidification of the oil, it is essential to bring both the system and the compressor to a good vacuum level during the installation phase or during maintenance. Replace the dehydrator filters as indicated by the manufacturer. Always purchase original spare parts. Finally, constantly monitor the oil quality using special tests in order to prevent the problem. If the test results are not optimal, replace the oil and clean the system in order to make the contaminants inert. If you like this video, subscribe to the channel and discover all Frascold's video trainings. Frascold, blue is better.